Have you heard the news? In .NET 9, Swagger is gone. But is this really true, or how do we get it back? Well, let's check it out real quick. When you have a look here, this is a typical new .NET web API project. So we're using the web API template here. And as you can see in the program CS, there's nothing about Swagger anymore. Instead, we have these two new lines, add open API and map open API. Now, what's that? When we hover over this thing here, it says adds open API services related to the default document to the specified iService collection. Doesn't really help, but then here we see register an endpoint onto the current application for resolving the open API document associated with the current application. So open API in the end is the specification of our web API. As you can see here in the Solution Explorer, we got our typical weather forecast examples. So when we run this now, we will get a JSON file out of the box. And then any tool you want to use to test your API manually, for instance, you can use any tool and load this JSON file in there. So let's try that first. I already started this application, but when I hit run, nothing is really happening. So maybe you are used to opening a browser automatically. Well, when we check out the launch settings JSON now, we see launch browser here is set to false. So let's just set this to true, maybe run this thing again. And then on my other screen here, a browser window is opening, but still we don't see anything. Now, when we want to access our configuration file from OpenAPI, we can do the following. We enter OpenAPI and then v1.json. So OpenAPI/v1.json. And as you can see here, now this is our configuration. We get the schemas, weather forecast, tags, and we also get the URLs and our path. And in this case, this is just the controller name for our get call, right? So when we double check here in the Solution Explorer, we go back to our controllers and the weather forecast controller. We now have here in brackets controller. So this is just a convention that says here the route is the controller name, in this case, weather forecast. When I change this and write, for instance, API slash then controller, restart the application and then go back to the browser, now you see API weather forecast. So this is just the configuration file, right? But how do we get Swagger back now? Well, it's easy. Real quick, if you want to level up your skills with .NET and Blazor, now is the time to join the .NET Web Academy. You get over 40 hours of pure learning content. We cover things like clean architecture and CQRS. We dive really, really deep into all the new render modes of Blazor. You will learn how to publish your web applications with the help of GitHub Actions and Azure. And you get access to our community and the brand new Discord server with live codecs. So make sure to use the link in the video description below for a huge discount. I'm really looking forward to seeing you inside the academy. So if you want to use Swagger, then you have to add the NuGet package, but there's also an alternative, and it seems the community is going to use Scala in the future, but let's just see what's happening, right? And by the way, if you don't know this, why did Microsoft ditch Swagger? Well, Swagger is not maintained anymore by its original owner. So this is the reason, but we still have updates to the whole Swagger and Swagger UI project, right? The community is implementing all that stuff. So we also have an update in .NET 9. So when we now go to our project and manage the NuGet packages, then go to browse, and here we just enter Swagger UI, and this is the package we need. Middleware to expose an embedded version of the Swagger UI from an ASP.NET Core application. As you can see, 676 million downloads. So yeah, Swagger is used pretty often actually. So this should work. And now to get Swagger back, we go to the program CS file, and under map open API, for instance, we can write app and then use Swagger UI. And then we need some information here. So options it is. And now we need an endpoint, and this is our configuration file, right? So here now I just say options and then Swagger endpoint. There it is. And here we enter again OpenAPI v1.json, and this thing also wants a name. So as a second parameter, we can enter something like our web weather API. All right, And that's everything. Now let's reload this thing again, restart the application. There's our configuration file. And now instead of OpenAPI v1 JSON, we just enter Swagger, and there's our beautiful Swagger bag, right? We can open this thing, try this out, hit execute, and we get our weather forecasts. But as I told you, there's also another option now. Well, there always has been this option, but maybe you're working on a project in a team where people are using Scala, for instance, because this seems to be now the trend. So what do you do then? Well, just right click your project, and here now you just look for Scala. And as you can see here, a Scala ASP.NET Core is the package, and we've got 80k downloads, so it is growing really fast. So let's install this thing. All right. And in this case, now we go to Program CS, and here we now write app and then map Scala API reference. As you can see, maps the Scala API reference endpoint, and that's it. No route whatsoever. We restart our application again. Now we go back to the browser. And now here, instead of Swagger, we now write Scala slash and then also v1 version 1, similar to the Open API version, right? So we do not configure the endpoint in the Program CS. It's here now done with the route you enter in the address bar. And as you can see, it is, well, it looks a little bit different, of course, but in the end it's very similar, because here we also see our endpoints. We can test the request, hit send, and here we get all our weather forecasts. And by the way, if you're interested, why V1 all the time? Well, this is default for this function here. So you can enter a name for your API, for instance, also V2, save that to restart our application. And as you can see here, V1 does not exist anymore, but V2 does. And similarly, when I now enter OpenAPI version 1 JSON, nothing there, but version 2 works. All right, and when this is done, then maybe you want to start building a web API, maybe even with Entity Framework. And if you want to learn this and dive really deep into these features, then I recommend you watch this video here on the screen.